To attempt to show you guys how I do my head wraps, and the particular wrap that I'm doing is the beehive, the one that sits on top of your head. I always call it the Badu wrap. I don't know the technical term, but it's the one that sits like Marge Simpson.
I got this from a culture shop, and I'm sorry, I'm all about black business, but you know we like to overcharge on things.
And I paid $20 for this, which is ridiculous. You can easily acquire this at a fabric shop. Forgive me of my lack of knowledge about the specific material. It's cottony with a little bit of stretch to it. I am 5'7", so the fabric goes from head to toe. And it's about this wide, but like I said, it stretches. Okay. I will be using two today, only because I like the look of big on top of my head. When I used to wear my micro braids, I was able to get away with just wearing one because, you know, I would sit the hair on top of my head and that would give me that extra oomph that I needed to get that leverage. But since I don't have that anymore, I'm going to use two. And if you have locks or braids or a full amount of poof to give you the bigness, then by all means just use one. But I've just been accustomed to using two. So I'm just going to ever so gently pin my hair on top. Now, I have brown and I have gray, and I want the gray to show, so I'm gonna go ahead and start with the brown. And basically what this is gonna do is just give me like a mold to work off of. Gonna wrap it around as such from the middle.
All right, can you turn it off so I can show you?
Now all I'm gonna do is take one side and swing it to the other and vice versa so that I have this going on right here.
And then what I do is just put that to the side, wrap one all the way around, and hold that in place as I wrap the other.
And just tucking this piece under. All right, and all I'm really trying to do is just get the shape. And then what I do is I just tuck the end. All right.
So I'm going to mold this a little bit to get the shape that I want.
All right, so there you have the skeleton. Now we're going in with the gray part. And we're gonna pull it over just like such, except I'm doing it from the edge, okay? And it's the same idea, covering that brown nice and tight down there and sliding that over. And we're gonna start wrapping the beehive. This time I'm taking it a little higher. Instead of like down here, I'm going to take it a little higher.
Alright, pulling it nice and tight. And wrapping that, those random pieces. Wrapping random pieces. Alright, now we're wrapping. And I'm tucking.
Tucking, tucking, tucking. Okay, so now you've got that. And you just start molding. Just start molding.
Sometimes I slide this all the way back so that there's like my hairline showing, almost like a headband. I don't think I'm gonna do that today though. I'm gonna keep it just right where it is.
So yeah, there it is. How's the back looking? Okay. There you go. Now, the downfall to this is, I'm gonna keep it 100. since I like to do it really tight, I do get a headache after a little bit, and I gotta start just trying to loosen it up a bit. Also, not the best style to go out for booty shaking, head bopping, dancing at the club. This thing will come off. It's on there. I'll take that back. Maybe you can. All right, I'll take that one back. And another problem is, you know, you'll find that the gay guys will love to touch and caress it. Let me stop for it. Not just gay guys. Mostly everybody, especially children. But the gay guys, it really means a lot coming from them. As an addendum to using just a regular wrap that I used, I'm going to see if I can do this with a wrap skirt. And I picked this up at like a random flea market. It's just this long wrap skirt. And it's A-line cut, so I'm going to attempt to fold it as evenly as possible, hamburger style. I'm folding hamburger. There's your kindergarten lesson for today, kids. Same concept as before, taking it from the edge, the end, I should say, and this is might be a holy hot mess, y'all. Let's see. Never tried this before. All right, so sweeping that the short leg over under the long leg and just start wrapping. I got a rat tail. Definitely have a rat tail on the back. One time, one of my former students came up on the scene with a rat tail, and he was like,
"Ah, I hate this rat tail, you know, my mom's making me keep it."
I was like, "Look, do you want the rat tail?" And he said,
"No, I don't want the rat tail. What should I do?"
I was like, "Have you tried talking to your mom?" He says,
"Of course, but she wants me to keep my hair."
So I said, "Well, it's your hair. You should be able to do what you want to do with it. What do you think is a solution for you, you know, getting rid of your rat tail?" He's like,
"Cut it off."
And I said, and the next day, his rat tail was gone. I mean, was that wrong? I mean, it's a rat tail. Like, who wears rat tails now? I feel like this is the African goddess queen crown of a rap, y'all. Ooh, let me get my drum. So it can be done. I was talking while I was doing it, so let me see. I don't know how the back looks. There's a bit of a bulge right there, but whatevs, I'm just doing this for fun. Yeah, it can be done. I would rock this. I would rock my skirt on my head. Yeah, so there's a friendly alternative. If you have a wrap skirt, I mean, I've seen it done with t-shirts somehow. I mean, it's not a high of a wrap, but I've seen it done with t-shirts. Yeah, there you go. Hope you guys have fun with it.